add the vRoid character. First of all, in your browser, you should be logging to the vRoid hub. Then here on the right side, if you will click on the arrow, the first of all you will see your characters. By clicking this, here will appear the characters which you have created into the vRoid studio. I haven't created anything, so here is empty. Also, if you would like to use the other characters created by other developers, you will see them here, characters you liked. I have a few of them. If there is nothing, so you can go back to the vRoid hub, scroll down to the latest characters, click on the View More, and you will see the page with the characters. And now, very important thing, if you will click on the character and scroll down, here on the right side you will see if you can download and use the character or no. Here is no, so you are not able to use this. So let's go back to the main page, and here in the filter by conditions you should click mark the checkboxes: third party use, yes; download, yes; avatar use, yes; commercial use by individuals, yes; non-profit activities by individuals, yes; attribution, yes; and then click OK. So you will see the different list, and then let's say that you would like to use this character. You're clicking on it, waiting for loading. Here she is. Scroll down, and as you can see, all conditions are yes, that you can use it, that you can download it, and so on and so on and so on. This character will work. Here you can see the heart. If you will click on it, as you can see, it changed the color. And after, when you go to the characters you liked, this character will appear here. So you have prepared the character which you would like to use. Let's go to the game. On the right side you see the button Load vRoid character from your vRoid account. Click on it. First is the drop down menu with the shaders which can be used. If you know which shader has been used, okay. If no, you can use, for example, the first one or experiment with this. The second drop-down menu is position. You can add up to 50 different characters. I'm selecting the 0 because I haven't added anything. Click the button Load vRoid characters from your vRoid account and wait to open. First, it opens yours. It means the characters created by you. As I have told, I haven't created anything, this is empty. Go to the liked characters, and as you can see, the characters I have liked are here. You can switch to English, waiting for loading. Click on the girl. Seems that nothing here has been translated to English, doesn't matter. Mark this checkbox, this is important. And then click on the button which is highlighted. Waiting for loading, the process is completed, and click here to go back to the game. Done. Now click the button Done. Let's make a very short timeline. So, open the timeline menu, add in the camera position, click the button Add Personal Switcher. Here, in the drop-down menu, select your vRoid character. She will be the last one. So, scroll down and here vRoid 00 model. Those 00 mean the position which you have selected when here was this window. selecting the model, activate her, and click the button Move character near the camera position. I has changed the position of my camera, so this is why I should move her. You can manipulate with this character exactly the same as you are manipulating with characters in the game. So you can move her, rotate her, and so on. So as you can see, everything is working perfectly.